Hello and welcome to Mangatora 96, and today we're going to talk about Arifureta Shokugyou de Sekai Saikyou. Today's topic will be the idealistic, the popular, the narcissistic, and the idiotic hero who was a big pain in the ass throughout the main story. However, he did thankfully get a redemption arc in the after story, so now he is not so idealistic, not so popular, and not so narcissistic, and definitely he is not so much of an idiotic hero anymore. I'm of course talking about Kouki. But before we start, here's the spoiler warning. I will be spoiling a lot of things in this video, so if you don't want to be spoiled, I would highly recommend that you go and read the light novel, as it is an enjoyable read. For everyone else, let's start with who Kouki is. Kouki Amanogawa is one of the students from Japan who got involved in the summoning incident and ended up in Tortoise along with his other classmates. He is somewhat like the leader of the whole class, as most of the students look up to him. This is further enforced by him being blessed with the rare job as the hero. Kouki is kind, fair, and overflowing with a sense of justice. However, because he thinks he's never wrong, Kouki always ignores reality and misinterprets situation to suit his own point of view. Like when he thought Hajime was taking advantage of Kaori's kindness and that she only spoke to him out of pity. This stems from his childhood. During his childhood, he greatly admired his grandfather that would teach him his ideals of righteousness and justice. After his grandfather's death, Kouki held to his teachings of ideals of righteousness. Even so, the righteousness that his grandfather taught didn't recognize good and evil at all. To further say it, Kouki came to think that what the majority of people thought as right was the absolute right. As he grew, he was capable of overcoming many problems by holding to his ideals. As a result, without realizing it, Kouki came to not doubt his own righteousness. Despite being cautioned by several people close to him, especially by his parents and Shizuko, he ignores them and simply believes his righteousness, making him quite arrogant, dim-witted, foolish and delusional about himself. This only worsened after being summoned to Tortoise, where the Holy Church and the Kingdom of Hylik labeled Kouki and his classmates as their heroes who were sent by God to save them from the demons, something he took absolute pride in believing. Because of his self-righteousness and egoism, Kouki can't accept it when things don't go his way, making him act like a spoiled child. That was seen when Kaori decided to follow Hajime of her own free will. He couldn't accept it as he always believed that they should be together forever and would rather believe that Hajime is the one who took her away. He further mistakes that all the girls who were following Hajime were being forced by him and tried to get them to come with him instead by saying he would treat them better than Hajime, which only greatly disturbed them because of how far off their mark he was. This only upset him further, causing Kouki to challenge Hajime to a duel for them, which was no different from him trying to take them away by force. Hajime noted the reason why he didn't bother telling him and the rest of their classmates about Ace's true nature as an evil god was because Kouki wouldn't want to believe that he was never a chosen hero and all his heroism efforts were completely pointless and would just get mad at him instead, something Kouki couldn't deny. Due to always being successful in everything he did back on Earth and being summoned to Tortoise as a hero, Kouki has developed immense narcissist pride in himself and his ability, as he believes that due to him being the hero, others should follow his lead and that he is the person who will save everyone. This is displayed when Hajime killed the demon Katalea over Koki's protest despite her previous attempt to kill the hero party and the kingdom's knights. As to him, killing a person was wrong and thus condemned Hajime for not following his commands. His arrogance even deluded him into believing that he is stronger than Hajime due to being blessed as Ace's chosen hero, even self-righteously challenging Hajime to claim his harem for himself. Where, when Kouki nearly died in Eri's death trap during Fritz's invasion and also witnessed Hajime's real power as not only destroyed a zombified Melt and the other Hylik Kingdom knights, even effortlessly killed Hiyama, one of the strongest of his fellow heroes, with his bare hands. Kouki's pride in himself was badly damaged, which worsened when Aiko exposed Ace's true nature as an evil god and his scheme in using him and his classmates as pawns in a mad game of death, in which all the hero worship Kouki had received from the Holy Church was nothing more than a fabricated lie. unable to accept his own failures and the truth about Ei, Kouki even attempted to vent his frustration on Hajime by blaming him for Ei's team in helping Eri and Hiyama's betrayal that led to the Heilig Kingdom's invasion by Frieda. Even when Hajime pointed out it was Koki's own personal flaws and naivety that led to Eri and Hiyama's betrayal, he still refused to acknowledge it, preferring to blame Hajime for the problems that he himself had caused due to his pride and arrogance in himself. Kouki was the only one who condemned Hajime for murdering Hiyama, despite the latter being a despicable traitor who killed Melt and the Heilig Kingdom Knights and also temporarily murdered Kaori, and attempted to make her his undead sex slave. He seeks to enforce his morals and ideals onto others as he believes that he knows what is best, as he often clashes with Hajime over what actions to take, as Hajime outright refused to follow Koki's ideals due to his pragmatic and realistic mindset. He gets irritated and annoyed when he learns that Hajime saved more people despite Hajime's ignorant reply to Tortoise and Koki's own desire to save everyone. Despite him inciting that Hajime take them along with him, Kouki doesn't wish to accept what he believes as charity from Hajime, as he strives to prove that he is right and stronger than Hajime. This is shown in the fact that Kouki is reluctant to use the upgrades to the holy sword that Hajime added. This desire to prove himself stronger to Hajime got worse after Kouki failed to clear the Haltenian Labyrinth, as that failure made him more irritated and increased his animosity towards Hajime. He is easily swayed by his emotions, making him increasingly reckless as he tends to act without thinking about the present situation. Even though this has been pointed out by Shizuku several times and has even almost got him killed, he rarely reflects on this issue. This has proven to be his greatest weakness, as he will hesitate when he learns new information about his enemy and always ending up giving them an opening to defeat him. This is seen during his second battle against Katleya, where he stopped his blade right after he succeeded in getting in close enough to finish her off due to seeing her giving her final prayer to her loved one as she prepared to die due to realizing that he was about to kill another sentient person and not a mindless monster, as he initially thought the demon race was. Eri also made use of this weakness by making the undead Melt appear as if he could be saved, causing Kouki to stop his blade once again before he could finish his opponent, getting defeated as a result. Another noticeable trait about Kouki is his denseness. Despite being very popular with many different girls on both Earth and Tortoise, he failed to notice this. Similarly, he completely failed to notice that his childhood friend Kaori already had feelings for Hajime back on Earth and instead believes she only talked to Hajime out of sympathy. Even when she confessed to Hajime right in front of him, he still couldn't believe it. It's because of this denseness that neither Shizuku or Kaori ever found themselves attracted to him, despite knowing him for so long. Another aspect to Kouki is his apparent innocence. After he and his classmates were summoned to Tortoise and the situation of the human demon war was explained to them and their role as heroes summoned from another world to help humanity defeat the demons, Kouki was completely oblivious to the true implications of their situation and instead got swallowed up by their glamour presented by the kingdom and the church of being the chosen heroes. This is seen where, unlike Shizuku and Hajime, Kouki failed to recognize the fact that they were now going to tangle up in an actual war against two races and thus were now doomed to face the inevitable prospect of having to kill sentient life in mass. A clear example of his innocence is seen during his second fight against Katleya, where Kouki stopped his blade and he was about to kill the demon due to the realization that he was about to kill another sentient being. Something Katleya berated him for, as they were two enemy combatants in opposing sides, as she also later revealed that Kouki most likely only ever considered and saw those of the demon race as animals or monsters and viewed the war against the demon race as simply hunting and was completely oblivious to the implication of a genuine war. As revealed by Hajime and acknowledged by his close friend Shizuko, despite those numerous negative traits, Kouki himself is completely and utterly oblivious to them. And due to things having always worked out for him in the end back on Earth in whatever he did, he himself developed the unconscious habit of automatically misdirecting and misidentifying his feelings in order to validate and mask his negative feelings and insecurities through his empty ideals of justice in order to cope with them, in order to be in the right instead of properly acknowledging them. While traveling through the frost cravens of Schnee, Kouki showed signs of growing increasingly unstable. Despite repeatedly saying he would save and protect everybody, he continually failed at every turn, including failing to clear the Haltenia Labyrinth. Worse for him, Kouki's own teammates were doing a better job than him and were getting praised from Hajime and his party for it. While facing his copy during the final part of the trial, he continued to deny everything his copy said, which only made it stronger as he wasn't accepting his own flaws. Once he saw Shizuku sleeping peacefully on Hajime's back, he completely snapped, choosing to believe Hajime was brainwashing everyone and everything would be returned to being right if he killed him. His logic likewise grew increasingly erratic, crazed, and delusional to the point that almost every assumption made by Kouki bore little to no relation or connection to the very situation, leading his close friends to wonder how he had even come up with this conclusion. Despite this, however, he still believed in whatever he made up due to refusing to accept his errors. However, he became doubtful after he almost broke his relationship with Kaori and Shizuku due to his stubborn adherence to misguided righteousness after he's effortlessly defeated by his former classmate Hajime. However, despite this and seeing how much Hajime suffered to get where he is, he still desperately wanted to believe he was right all along. This made it easy for Eri to brainwash him and make him her puppet, all which ironically thinking his friends were the ones being brainwashed. Interestingly, this was exactly what the Haltenian Labyrinth and the first Cavern of Schnee tried to prepare those who planned to challenge the gods for. The gods will turn them against their friends and manipulate their inner weaknesses. This proves once again why Kouki failed to clear both labyrinths. In the afterstory, due to his past failures and mistakes, he has lost his childishness and naivety along with most of his confidence and has become far more insecure and guilty due to not trusting his own judgment. This is reflected on the fact that he is initially more inclined to be enlisted to help others. After meeting Moana and the people of Sinclair Kingdom, Kouki was able to find his answer and not hesitate anymore, killing several thousand dark beings to save Arquitia. His growth and his desire to save Moana impressed Hajime enough that he lent his power to save the kingdom, so Kouki could save the woman he fell for. Due to this, he was able to make peace to Hajime as both acknowledged each other by hating the other, in contrast to Hajime's previous dismissal of him and Kouki affirming that despite his dislike of Hajime, he admires his resolve and his ability to push forward no matter what. With this, I covered everything that I wanted to cover on Kouki. And that will be all for this video. If you like this video, leave a like, leave your thoughts in the comments below, or subscribe to the channel for more manga reviews and One Piece content. And until next time, take care.